Olive oil fraud has been around for thousands of years, but as rising demand transforms EVOO into an increasingly valuable commodity, and fraudsters find ingenious new ways of counterfeiting it, the reasons why your olive oil is probably fake continue to grow. This is why this fraud continues. Surprisingly, Italy only makes 15% of the world's olive oil. Even so, as The Guardian reports, it's the second largest exporter of olive oil after top producer Spain, which dominates 45% of the global market, but with prices 60% cheaper than Italy's. That makes Made in Italy designations both highly coveted and highly falsified. As the New York Times warned, much of the extra virgin Italian olive oil flooding the world's market shelves is neither Italian nor virginal. So, wait, what's going on here? As Larry Olmsted, author of Real Food, Fake Food, notes, much of the oil that comes from Italy is bottled but not produced there. In recent years, countless undercover operations by the Italian police have uncovered massive scams in which tons of cheap, low-quality oils from Syria, Turkey, North Africa, and Spain are being bottled and sold as authentic Italian extra virgin to foreign markets. Among the biggest victims of this olive oil fraud is the U.S., to which Italy exports around 30% of its olive oil. In 2013, a report published by the European Parliament crowned olive oil as Europe's most counterfeited agricultural product. Despite attempted legislation and crackdowns, a 2020 report by the U.S.'s American Botanical Council found that adulteration of olive oil is still rampant. The report highlights two major reasons for the ongoing fakery: low availability of high-quality olive oil and soaring demand. Much more valuable and beneficial than other vegetable and seed oils, all-natural extra virgin olive oil involves much more care, time, and effort to produce. Faking it amounts to making it, in terms of money. The financial rewards have skyrocketed in keeping with demand. According to Statista, in the last 20 years, Americans' olive oil consumption has increased by 58%. At the same time, Olive Oil Times reports that falling levels in Italy, as well as other Mediterranean olive-producing countries such as Greece, Portugal, and Tunisia, mean that worldwide production levels in 2020 are down at the same time as demand is soaring, particularly for high-quality extra virgin olive oil. A big reason for all the fake EVOO on supermarket shelves can be traced to the Italian mafia, or rather, the agri-mafia. With counterfeit olive oil offering profit margins as high as 700%, organized crime has switched from drugs to more lucrative yellow gold. As one EU investigator observed in The New Yorker, profits are comparable to cocaine trafficking, with none of the risks. A 60 Minutes investigation found that authentic, additive-free EVOO can sell for $50 a gallon. Fake olive oil costs a mere $7 to produce. As Securing Industry explains in Italy, the agri-mafia has infiltrated every step of the supply chain from farm to table. Organized crime influence extends from the price of olive crops and the way the fruit is transported and sorted, to doctoring oil and mislabeling bottles. Even bottles stamped with protected designation of origin, PDO labels, which certify the contents hail from a renowned Italian olive oil region, where they were subject to controls, have been subject to counterfeit. The agri-mafia even has control over supermarket chains, which helps explain why an estimated 50% of olive oil in Italian supermarkets is fake. In 2019, experts estimated the agri-mafia's annual turnover is around $29 billion. One reason fakery is so common is due to countless myths and misinformation surrounding olive oil. The Guardian journalist Alex Renton recounts conducting a blind EVOO tasting in which a panel of experts, an olive oil importer, an Italian deli owner, and some renowned foodies were given a dozen products to rate. The outcome was humiliating. The importer rated his own premium product disgusting. The deli owner praised a suspect Italian extra virgin oil purchased for $2.37 at a discount store. And the foodies favored the scandal-tainted Bertolli brand, a leading brand in the U.S. In Extra Virginity, Tom Mueller describes how Bertolli succeeded due to a perverse twist in European law that, until 2001, permitted any olive oil bottled in Italy to be sold as Italian olive oil. According to Mueller, around 80% of Bertolli's oil wasn't from Italy at all, despite references on the label. Moreover, like many of its competitors, Bertolli advertised its olive oils as being smooth and gentle, adjectives associated with low-quality and doctored olive oils. A characteristic of authentic EVOOs are their bold flavors, often described as bitter and pungent. Consequently, many brands succeed at selling low-quality oils at high prices, and producers of authentic EVOO have difficulty selling the real deal because ill-informed consumers deem them to be overpriced and unpleasant-tasting.
Didn't you lose a lot of money on that other investment, the one from the email?
You know what, Toby? When the son of the deposed king of Nigeria emails you directly asking for help, you help.
While making high-quality extra virgin olive oil is a complex, time-consuming, and expensive process, as Tom Mueller points out, faking it is relatively easy, rapid, and cheap. One of the most common counterfeit methods is to mix EVOO with lower-grade olive oils from other countries, or with other oils such as canola, soy, and even hazelnut oil. Counterfeit oil is also deodorized, which involves producing oil from actual rotten olives. On its own, deodorized oil is inedible. However, after undergoing a gentle refining process that leaves few telltale chemical traces, this neutral oil can be blended with real olive oil and sold as extra virgin. Today, deodorized oil accounts for a significant portion of the fake olive oil that ends up on the world's supermarket shelves. In recent years, quality inspectors have gotten increasingly wise to these deodorized oils. However, as Mueller concedes, there are so many different and increasingly sophisticated high-tech methods of deodorizing olive oil that the fraudsters are always seemingly a few steps ahead of the authorities. As methods of adulterating olive oil become more sophisticated, it's increasingly difficult for olive oil specialists and law enforcement, let alone consumers, to detect a fake. Such scams often operate at high-tech refineries, and the resulting product is difficult to detect via chemical analysis. Recognizing that laboratory tests often fail to detect fakes, in 1991, the European Union established strict taste and aroma requirements for all grades of olive oil. The EU also created official tasting panels certified by the UN's International Olive Oil Council. Yet, the North American Olive Oil Association argues taste tests aren't accurate indicators of purity because tasters can't always detect adulteration. While testers may be highly trained, purity can only be measured in a laboratory. The problem with lab tests, however, is the sheer scale involved with applying them to all potentially suspect oil. Bottom line? It's still a major challenge to detect fraud. While taste tests and lab tests have their pros and cons, the biggest problem with testing olive oil's purity is that it often doesn't occur at all. As a 2020 article in Food Control underscores, even the most sophisticated methods are only applied to EVOO fraud incidents after the fact. So, while testing might reduce the impact of a specific discovered fraud, they do little to prevent future incidents. According to The New Yorker, Italian authorities rarely carry out panel tasting tests. If they do, the tests only take place once the offending olive oil has already been bottled and sold. And if an oil does fail a taste test, it's common for powerful oil producers to demand a retest from a more favorable panel, or to appeal the verdict by claiming the samples were tampered with. In 2015, the National Consumer League conducted a study, purchasing 11 popular olive oil brands from major retailers, including Whole Foods, Safeway, and Giant, only to discover that 6 out of the 11 weren't extra virgin at all. As Times reported, while NCL identified the 5 oils that passed the test, those that failed were kept secret. As NCL's executive director, Sally Greenberg, revealed, this was because the companies accused of faking it made a huge stink. In 2019, the NCL conducted a follow-up study and discovered that half the bottles tested still failed to meet international standards for EVOO. Such findings are all too common. Forbes cites an investigation into 7 reputed Italian olive oil producers. Among them Bertoli, Sasso, and Carapelli that allegedly found all guilty of selling adulterated olive oil as extra virgin made in Italy. Recently, Cello Olive published a list of offending labels embroiled in accusations of fraudulent oil, and among them are some of the leading brands on America's supermarket shelves. As olive oil expert/taster David Newman stresses, after the press that olive oil fraud has received over the years, supermarkets are aware of what they're stocking. If some retailers turn a blind eye to potentially fraudulent oils so that they can compete for customers with affordable prices, many consumers are only too willing to participate, seduced by bargain prices, well-known reputable brands, and meaningless industry buzzwords such as pure, Italian, and traditional, they ignore any misgivings as they head to the checkout counter. Newman believes that over time, consumers have become conditioned to buying inexpensive bad oils, even if they're ashamed to admit they're encouraging ongoing fraud. As he tells Forbes, the chain stores keep buying because it sells, and everybody has become addicted to the low prices. Because of this, there's no incentive for retailers to stock authentic EVOO that is more expensive.
May I help you?
Oh, no thanks, sir. Just browsing.
Olive oil fraudsters are also encouraged by the absence of government control over olive oil imports. As David Newman confessed to Forbes, the U.S. is the, quote, dumping ground for fraudulent olive oil, adding that it lacks the resources to monitor over 350,000 tons of olive oil entering the country annually. According to Larry Olmsted, the Food and Drug Administration has been aware about EVOO fraud for decades. Yet, based on its failure to conduct consistent testing, it seemingly views such fraud as relatively rare, or an issue of little importance. Tom Mueller cites an FDA official who says the agency prefers to focus on products where there's an obvious public health issue. However, as a top European food fraud investor explained to 60 Minutes, if you adulterate EVOO with seed oil, such as peanut or sunflower oil, and contaminated bottles reach consumers who are allergic, you are sending them bombs. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more MASH videos about your favorite foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.